Good morning.
How you doing?
Well, faithful, it is a good looking Thursday morning. Great day to be alive in the Lord, giving him thanks.
You're right, and you know what? It's a great, great, great day to hear a powerful word from God, Pastor.
Hey, always delighted to be sharing the word of God.
All right, Tennessee Valley, we got him on the line, Pastor Mark Meadows, with Christ in Action. Take it away, Pastor.
All right, indeed, delighted to be sharing the good news this morning, and the center of our message is Christ himself. And more importantly, Christ in you. That is the great mystery that Paul said he was sent to unveil, Colossians chapter 1 and verse 27. And so we carry on this truth of Christ in you. He indeed came on our behalf, and God was in him reconciling the world to himself, not laying our sins to our account, but taking them into himself to take them away, and making us then, as we embrace him, his ambassadors, as he then works and lives in us. And we become Christ in action in the world today. Well, we're beginning to conclude our series from the month of June on God's gifts in you. And we've been talking about the motivational gifts, and these are simply the gifts that are unique to you, your spiritual gifts, your heart, your abilities and aptitudes, your personality, your experience. Yes, all of these things in the hand of God are his workmanship, his handiwork in you. The scripture says in 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 9, that embracing him and our place in his family, we become a royal priesthood, a chosen generation, a peculiar or his special people who show forth his praises or the virtues of the one who called us out of darkness into the marvelous light. Showing forth the virtues of God is, yes, giving glory to him, worshiping him in spirit and in truth, as the Lord Jesus described, and saying thank you and giving him praises and speaking of his holiness, his righteousness, his love, his grace, his wisdom, his power, all of those things. But showing them forth and showing those virtues through us, I believe, is God expressing himself through us. And it comes through how he has uniquely crafted each one of us, shaped us, and formed us. And as scripture says in 2 Timothy chapter 1 and verse 9, called us with a holy calling, not according to our righteousness, but according to his grace given unto us in Christ before the world began. So that means that God had intent and purpose in our design from the very beginning. And just as he in Genesis chapter 1 made all things and put its seed in itself such that it would reproduce after its kind, so likewise when it came to man, he invested himself in us, Genesis chapter 1 verse 26 and Genesis chapter 2 and verse 7, that we might be a living expression of him. Now, that having been said, we're talking about these seven motivational gifts from Romans 12, verses 6 through 9, or 8 rather, where we talked about prophecy and the gift to just encourage people, speak to them for their edification, exhortation, and comfort. You know, people like that, they're just constantly, you know, you feel good being around them because you know you're going to be uplifted in some way. You're going to be built up. You're going to be encouraged. We all can do that, but then some have that gift. So you have that gift, recognize it and use it for the glory of God. And then it talks about serving in verse number 7. We talked about this some yesterday, how that acts of service is some of the way many people express their love. They enjoy just doing things for neighbors, for friends, for coworkers. And we all can do that, but then some are gifted in this way. Understand that it is a gift of God if you're wired in that way. Then there's teaching. You know, there's teaching like I do on this broadcast every day. But then there's also mentoring. There's parenting. There's being a big brother, a big sister. There's volunteering and reaching out to mentor people around you and in the community, sharing with them the knowledge that you experience that you have to do them good. So that too is teaching, and you know, recognize that gift in you. Then today we want to talk about exhortation, and he says exhortation, or being someone who is always seeking to better a situation, speaking to constantly advance something. A person who's an exhorter is always committed to the just call, what is right, what is righteous, wanting to see the best in things, and will also always be pushing to see the very best, never settling for less than what is best. And so that too is a gift. Now, I'm not talking about perfectionism, where being critical or mean-spirited and always tearing people down, but it is an exhortation gift to be able to encourage and to exhort to what is best. I believe a good parent is an exhorter because it's always trying to bring the best out of the child. That's why the scripture says, train up a child in the way that he or she should go, and when he or she is old, they won't depart from it. To do that, I believe, requires to be an exhorter. And so in parenting, you have to be that. There's other things, leadership, and in various roles and capacities. But know that if you are always desiring to see the best in things and feel compelled to speak up, that is a gift. And not only just to speak up, but to step up and to do something about it. That's a gift of God. Honor that gift. Lend your talents, abilities to bring out the best in people and in situations and things. We need that in our world. Well, that's it. That's good news today. We're going to continue and wrap this up tomorrow, I believe. But today, hey, go ahead and do your part to show the virtues of God, talking about and reaching for the best of what God has designed in your life, and encouraging the same in the lives of others, in our community, in our environment, our state, our nation, our world. That's God's gift at work in you, me, us all. This has been an outreach of Connected Church. Connect with us, connected.church.com. Follow us on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. There you will find these and other encouraging words. Build you up in your faith and the love that God has for you, the identity that you have in Him, that together we're the difference that makes the difference that God desires and we desire. So we awaken His purpose of knowing Him and the love He has for us, mobilized His mission of making Him known and sharing His love with others. That's good news today, faithful.
All right. Thank you for that powerful word. We needed that bright and early this morning, Pastor. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much for what you do for us every single day. Lord willing, we'll talk to you again real soon.
All right. Blessings on you and your family.
Same to you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right. Let God's gift flow through you today. The best gift is the one that's needed and the one that God has put in you for the people who are around you and for you. Let it flow and let it grow today. We'll talk to you again real soon.